And we are remembering a member of the KFMB family who went on to revolutionize the morning talk show format.
Beloved TV host Regis Philbin has passed away at the age of 88, and we are hearing from those who had the privilege to work with him. So joining us now, Jackie Jordan, a friend of Regis. You worked with him as a consultant on the talk show circuit. So good to have you here. Good morning, Jackie.
Hi, thank you so much, Eric and Netta. Can you believe the legendary Regis Philbin started in your seats?
I know. Yeah, we're so bummed to hear that this weekend. I mean, you know, former KFMB here. He worked here as a host. We've been enjoying seeing some of the old pictures of him here. Mm-hmm. And boy, he went on. Just a incredible career he had.
To the younger generation, I say that he's the Ryan Seacrest. And when they were in school, of course, when the great Live with Regis and Kathy Lee, and then later Live with Kelly was on the air during daytime. But he's holds the record, the world's record for the longest time on television for live hours, if anybody can even imagine that. He's like 19,000, something like that, hours. But he's been with almost 40-year career. And you know what's so amazing about Regis is that, you know, in 2020, where this is the year that we're learning that, you know, not everything you see is what you get. Right. Regis really was one of those people who is authentic and was, you know, the person you saw on the air is the person that he is. And many of my colleagues who had the privilege of working with him closer than even I did really have profound affection and really great respect for the man that he was. Big personality, really quick with his one-liners. And as you both know, Eric and Netta, it is not easy to do live television day in and day out every single day.
Oh, no. And he had so much energy and warmth to him. But let's talk about your relationship with him. When was the first time you met him? How did you work together?
I know him through the circuit, because there's a whole group of us. There's a pretty tight-knit group of us in the talk show community who some worked closer with him than, of course, that I did. But I know him through the events, the Emmys committees, and all of the events that we did. I was New York City talk show producer in the '90s during a lot big part of his heyday.
You talked a little bit about how he was just who he was on TV, you know. So tell us a little bit about what he was like behind the scenes.
He was really great at his sense of humor, his quips. Yeah. Anybody that met him, he made you feel like he knew you. You were an endeared friend. There wasn't a different persona for him on air than there was off air, and for a lot of people that's very unique. You know, when they're on air, they're literally on. And when they're off air, they're very off. But, you know, Regis really carried that all the way through. He often co-hosted with his wife, Joy. He's got a lovely, lovely, lovely family. We wish them the best at this time.
Yeah, of course. It was so heartbreaking to hear the news. And then I think for a lot of people, they didn't realize his connection to our station, to KFMB here in San Diego.
No.
Yeah. And he really rose to these national ranks very quickly in his career, right? When he first started, and it's a natural thing for him to, draw viewers at any level.
It's, almost 40 years on television, starting the sidekick to the Joey Bishop. But, the younger generation, of course, knows from whose line is it anyway.
Right.
Would you like to call your lifeline right now? We know him, of course, from, daytime television forever, and also previously with the game shows. Yeah, it's definitely it's a passing of a real legend.
As someone who knew him,
daytime talk shows.
What would you want people to remember about Regis? A lot of our viewers have grown up watching him, whether it's the Millionaire Show or the morning talk shows. I mean, he was all over our TV screens. I mean, what do you want people to remember about Regis?
He was a real friendly face. He also, reminds me almost of that the Mr. Rogers kind of energy. Mm-hmm. He was just very friendly, real quick, easy going, but really worked hard. You know, I don't think there was a, you know, they say Ryan Seacrest works really hard. I think Regis Philbin really, really worked hard. He was traveling back and forth from New York to LA doing his daytime show right up till about, a decade ago. So he definitely, was a really great person. We're sorry to see him pass.
Yeah, I was looking up just his credits and everything he's done. He was working up until 2011.
Amazing.
I mean, he just loved what he did, and you could see that. You could see that passion in him. Yeah. And that's what we're all going to miss about Regis. Jackie, thanks so much for sharing your time with us. And
thank you, Eric and Meta.
I know it's good to get that perspective from people who worked with him. Not a single person has anything bad to say about Regis, that's for sure. Thank you, Jackie.